Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Warmly welcoming you to the third day of the world's first virtual dental implant expo 2020, organized by your very own dental media company, dentistchannel.online. My name is Ruben Lobo. I am your host, your moderator, and your friend for this session. And together, let's this session as the best session, because this is the session where you would be taught how to make right and diligent decisions when it comes to looking out for that perfect CBCT or an OPG machine for your dental or your implant practice. Ladies and gentlemen, we have with us a very special speaker, a person who's been doing a phenomenal job when it comes to OPGs, CBCTs, and other medical devices with regards to dentistry. Dr. Vijay Kumar, ladies and gentlemen, as most of you all know, you might have seen him in number of dental conferences, number of dental events, symposiums, expos, who's going, convincing, and telling the people about the USPs and technical specialties of a particular product. The last time we met Dr. Vijay in Delhi, we saw there were at least 50 people surrounded to his booth, listening to him while he is giving the technical specifications. And that's when we thought, why not we have Dr. Vijay himself talking about how to select and how to make diligent decisions when it comes to choosing the ideal CBCT or OPG machine for your implant or your dental practice. And ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege and an honor to invite and welcome and thank our speaker, Dr. Vijay Kumar. Most of you all know what Dr. Vijay Kumar has been doing in his professional career. Still a short bio of Dr. Vijay Kumar. Dr. Vijay Kumar has been in the sales and marketing business of X-rays, PSPs, IOS, OPG, and CBCT machines. He's been into training of sales and service team for more than 50 people at one go. He's been into giving demonstrations of OPG and CBCT software applications to doctors, institutes, diagnostic centers, colleges, etc. He's been into the management of installation data for all dental radiology equipments. He's known for his competitor market business studies, strategy, and equipment analysis when it comes to medical devices. He's also been into research and analysis related to CBCT softwares like On-Demand 3D, InVivo, ExoCal, 3DS, Oscar, Astra, OpenRTK, Slicer, etc. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting to you the CBCT man himself, Dr. Vijay Kumar, all the way from India. Over to you, Dr. Vijay.
So thank you so much, Ruben, and I really thank to dentistchannel.online for creating and organizing such a big, wonderful and beautiful event for all the doctors across India and the world. So we can witness the power of internet and the power of technology, so through which we are connecting to a single point, and we are going to discuss amazing topic, because this topic to choose a OPG and CBCT for all dental practitioner and people is really a big topic and a big decision. So I also welcome all the dental fellows, my juniors, colleagues, my dental fellows, my seniors, and all the dental practitioners to this event. And I will take this session in two segments, one for the presentation part, a second for the question answer round. So let me share my screen and we will go further. So Rukin, please help me whether the screen is visible or not.
The screen is visible, sir. Please make it full screen.
Okay. So good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The topic for today's session is how to choose right OPG and CBCT for implant practice. And my name is Dr. Vijay Raj, and I've done my graduation from Government Dental College, PGMS, Rohtak in 2010. And after that, I practiced a couple of years with Safdarjung Hospital, Delhi, and Apollo Hospital. And I did my post-graduation in hospital management administration and MBA in marketing and sales. So from the last 7 to 8 years, I'm in different domains of the dental equipment to do the research and the testing of the basically the radiologic equipment, because I found the dental radiology is the very, very most important topic and most important segment, where the diagnosis start. If we are doing the good diagnosis, we are doing the great treatment. So this is a very big question and concern for a lot of practitioners who are planning to purchase a OPG or CBCT, what to choose, how to choose. So what we are going to cover in this session is there any best OPG CBCT or the right OPG or CBCT? Basic factors for selection of OPG and CBCT, top brands comparisons, future aspects, conclusion, offers, and Q&A, question answer round. So this is very golden statement, whatever I did in my last 10 years, I feel it takes years to earn at least 8 lakh rupees for OPG and 30 to 40 lakh rupees for CBCT. But it takes minutes to spend it. Because if we are planning to purchase an OPG or CBCT, we do a lot of work hard in our clinic practice, we save money every year, then we plan to spend it in an OPG or CBCT to enhance our practice to upgrade our clinic. But it will take just a minute or second to just sign the check, take a machine. So a right decision can speed up the practice and a wrong decision can slow down it. Because many times in some wrong influence or some wrong information, we purchase a machine, but later on we found we are struggling with service issues or some other clinical or technical issues with the machine. So OPG is a very big decision for practice. It's really a big decision. Many dentists dream about CBCT is really a big dream, because if you are have your own CBCT for personal practice, it is considered as one of the biggest investment in dental practice. So CBCT and CAD CAM, these are the two main dreams for which a dental practitioner always think about in life, ki someday I will have my personal CBCT, my personal CAD CAM system. So for on this session is all the periodontists, because they are doing the lot of implants daily, oral and maxillofacial surgeons, prosthodontics, endodontics, now they are also doing implant practice. Now there are a lot of courses through which general practitioner, orthodontist, BDS doctor, students, OMR, oral pathologist, so everybody is now capable enough to do implant practice at least independently, because we have a lot of courses, we have a lot of support system through our seniors or through our dental colleagues, which are giving a lot of lessons, techniques, and their own experience through different courses. So now we are able to do implant practice. So these are the only three things through which we are starting or we are planning for implant, normal RVG. So this is the first thing, then OPG, then CBCT. So these are the three logical equipment through which we can do our practice. So I just want to summarize the basic indication. As a dental practitioner, we know endodontics, oral maxillofacial surgery, orthodontics, periodontics, periodontics, all the segments of dentistry require CBCT. So there is no department left through on which we can't use CBCT. We can use CBCT in every department, in every segment of our dental practice. So now the question is, the main core question is how to select the best OPG or CBCT. And my answer is, there is no best OPG and CBCT in the world. There is no best OPG and CBCT in the world, because if it were, everyone would buy it. So now the next question is, what does it mean? Because there is only right OPG and CBCT, not the best. So what does it mean? What is the best and what is the right? Right means according to your practice, according to your need. Because every doctor has their own mindset, their own requirement to use a CBCT as per their own practice guideline, own practice segment. So how to select the right one now? So the question is how to select the right OPG and right CBCT. So these are the basic points for which OPG and CBCT we should check at least. So if you are planning to purchase an OPG and you are planning to purchase a CBCT, so these are the basic points you must keep in your mind always, ki what type of sensor we are looking for a machine. So nowadays the CMO sensor are considered the best sensor, because if the detector or sensor is really good, the image clarity and the image formation is amazing. So OPG and CBCT both should have CMOS flat panel sensor or detector. Next, in case of OPG, because we are purchasing OPG to cover the more number of clinical cases. So all the type of OPG, all the type of panorama images like standard OPG, orthogonal OPG, wide beam, child panorama views, these should be covered by a machine. In case of sinus planning, if you are planning for sinus lip surgery or sinus graft surgery for implant practice, then at least sinus PA view, sinus lateral view, and lateral view, these are the three view which can cover the sinus portion of the implant practice. Then in case of TMJ planning, if you want to check the TMJ, then later TMJ, combined open close mouth, then PA, TMJ and the combo of the both. These are the basic views which should be covered by OPG machine at least. Then if you are planning for cephalometric arm, if you have any trauma center or any diagnostic center, or you have ortho practice as a professionally, then you can use the cephalometric arm for complete lateral set, skull PA, skull AP, cemento vertex, Waters view and carpus view. So if you are planning an OPG for a diagnostic center, these are the basic points which should be present in a single machine. So there are few machines which are covering all the features. There are few other machines which are covering two or three less features. So the machine should be open device. It means face-to-face position. Face-to-face means ki there is a patient, there is an assistant. So patient and assistant should be face-to-face to set the patient, to align the patient in a well manner. And at least 5 years warranty, which are covered by every company in India now. So in case of CVCT, so we should need at least the CMO's flat panel sensor and dedicated sensor for both OPG and CVCT. So this is a very specific point. If you are planning for CVCT, it means you need at least one sensor for OPG, one sensor for CVCT. But many companies are just giving one common sensor for CVCT. But we know if there is a CVCT machine, so 50 to 80% time we will do only 2D image, either the OPG image or TMJ or sinus image. So out of 10, only 3 or 4 cases are the CVCT cases and 6 and 7 cases are the OPG cases. So every time you are using CVCT machine as an OPG machine, but you have paid the amount of CVCT. So it means with the time, the CVCT sensor start deteriorating, because if you are using a sensor has a life. So you are using a CVCT sensor for OPG usage, and with time the sensor life start decreasing. So 7, 8, 9 years after, you will realize the CVCT sensor start working less. So that's why we always choose a CVCT having the dedicated sensor for OPG and CVCT. So now we have multiple FOVs, field of views. Like for endo practice, there is a different small FOV. For single arch or single quadrant, we have different FOV. For complete jaw, we have different FOV. For mid-face, we have different FOV. So these are the FOVs for the practice. If you are doing any pterygoid implant or you are planning for zygoma implant, then you need big FOV to check the end point of the any implant in the zygoma bone. So in case of resolution, if you are looking for high quality images, then we need 70 to 1400 microns. It means 70 microns for the endo purpose and 200 to 400 microns for the complete face. So a CVCT must have the implant library, because you don't know what type of implant you are practicing. Some are practicing adding, some are practicing local biocage, some are different companies, Dentium, they are different companies. So at least there is a complete implant library within the library of the software portion. So at least you have bone density measurement either in the HU unit, hospital unit, or in the D1 to D5 classification. So you must have metal artifact reduction feature, because if you are doing any implant planning, if there is any pre-implant or any crown is there, so there is a destruction of the radiation part. So we must have metal artifact reduction feature in a CVCT. The volume rendering, oblique slicing, at least 5 years warranty. So these are the basic points which should be checked in every OPG and CVCT at least. Apart from these are the different features with every type of CVCT. So the ideal choice for implant is only CVCT. We can't do the professional implant practice, accurate implant practice with OPG only. But CVCT is the only choice we should do. But it's struggling in India because of the two main factors. First factor is money. So money have two components, one for the doctor part, one for the patient part. Because if you want to do accurate implant practice 100% sure, then we have to spend 30-40 lakh rupees in CVCT. So which is not the easy investment for every doctor to purchase a CVCT. Second, for the patient, because if the patient is getting any CVCT, he have to pay extra. If we are sending patient to any diagnostic center, he have to pay extra money to 1,000, 3,000 as per the charge of the patient. So second is the time. Because if a doctor is sending the patient to any diagnostic center, so there is a loss of patient, because patient is preferring only the single day, practice single day dentistry. So either patient have to take one more day leave if he is an employee, or if he has any shop, he has any own business, then he have to take one more leave or one more day to spend to the clinic. So in that case, If doctor is sending a patient to the diagnostic center, there is a chance of loss of patient. Here, if patient is going to center, then he will think I will come it again after next week or next week. So there is a chance of losing the patient. So now these are the factors which influence a doctor to purchase a CBCT. So what type of manufacturer you are looking, trader, dealer, and reference or influence. So these are the four components on which doctor have to check, because these four area will decide to what type of CBCT or OPG you are planning to purchase. So first we will see in manufacturer category. So first you have to check the manufacturer of the machine of OPG and CBCT, either it is a Korean model or non-Korean model. Because in India, if you see, there are a lot of companies of OPG and CBCT, so they are divided into two main categories. One is Korean, one is non-Korean. So in Korean model, we have to check from how many years it is present in India, in how many years it present in other countries, then non-Korean companies present in India, any non-Korean companies means either the German model, Italian model, Finland, USA, and Canada. So these are the 5-6 main companies which is available in India through different traders and dealers. So you must check the origin, because if suppose there is a company you are choosing for one company, company A. So you have to check either the company A is a total manufacturing company only in the radiological equipment. Are they specialized company only to manufacture radiology equipment? So there are a lot of companies which are just hiring a third vendor, they are just putting their logo on the machine. So you have to check whether the company is only the dedicated company, specialized company in manufacturing of radiological equipment. Second, the presence in market. Since how many years they are present in India. Third, they are the installation base. Number versus time. Number versus time means, suppose the company started in 2015, then in how many years the growth pattern you have to check. In first year, the installation base is supposed 30 OPG or 5 CBCT, then in next year how many OPG they installed, then in next year how many CBCT they installed. So you have to check the market acceptance, because if the installation is increasing with time, you are getting the good feedback, machine quality is already testing, then you can check, yes, my choice is correct. You must check whether the OPG or CBCT is installed in government, diagnostic or corporate hospital, because government hospital will check the load of the machine. If suppose in government hospital, some hospital are doing 100 OPGs per day, because they have completed all the departments, there are a lot of patient load, there are a lot of PG, UG students. So suppose if the OPG or CBCT is in a government college, they will test the quality in terms of loading, how many patients we can do in overflow. Second, diagnostic center will tell you the quality in terms of software feature, because they have to do the precise work. And third, the corporate. So corporate hospital do a lot of R&D before choosing a OPG or CBCT for their hospital, because they have to do everything in a high level. Either they are the NABH accreditation hospital or ISO certified hospital or JCI certified hospital. So government hospital, diagnostic centers and corporate center will decide a machine quality in every terms. In patient load, in features of the machine, and in R&D purpose. So you must check the machine you are planning to purchase, they are installed in government, private sector, or diagnostic center, no. So then the direct or distributor company. It means either the company is present directly in India, in how many years, from how many years, or the main distributor is exclusive or not. Exclusive means only that one distributor is handling that OPG or CBCT pan India. There is no multiple distributor. Because if there is a multiple distributor, you will get a service problem. If there is only one distributor pan India, that is the right choice. So now, if we cover the second point, trader or exclusive distributor. So first, you have to check the profile of the trader company. Trader company means they are importing the machine and they are reselling the machine in India, but they are providing the post-sale service support. Second option is past experience. Past experience means if there is a complete trader or distributor, then you can check your experience with that trader or distributor. Third is presence in your area. If that distributor dealer is present in area or not. So the first point, trader company, you have to check how many years they are present in India. Because if they are present in India, then pan India offices you have to check. Dealers network you have to check. For example, in trader companies, we have few more big companies, like there is a Confident, there is company, Chasa companies, there are unicorn companies there. So they are the big trader companies. They import the high quality equipment from different manufacturers of the world, and they distribute in India through their own distribution channel network. So these companies are present in the last more than 20 years. It means they are the well established trader, or they are well established exclusive distributor of the high brand equipment. Like in case of laser, there is Boyle's laser. In case of CAD/CAM sister, they are German companies here. They are in-house scanners are there from Rudy's company. They are different. Then CAD/CAM system is different. The three shape scanners are different. So these are the companies which are importing the really great brand equipment in India, and they are distributing through their own network. So past experience of your past experience with any product. So this is the point which you have to remember. Never judge on a basis of bad service experience of a small equipment in comparison to OPGN CPCB. For example, you purchase a handpiece, or you purchase any ultrasonic scaler, or you purchase any basic chair of 1 lakh rupees. So after warranty or within a warranty period, you face any problem, it will take little extra time or 2 days or more to solve that problem. So it doesn't mean if you purchase a OPGN CPCB, you will face the same service problem. Because you can't compare a normal Maruti car service experience to a Audi car service experience. Both are the different segment, both are the different team, both are the different service department. So CBC team, OPG is a very high-end equipment, but they have very dedicated service engineers. And in normal equipment, handpieces like a scaler or normal basic chair, they have different service engineers. So never judge a past experience for purchasing any equipment with a company. And third is presence in your area. That means, suppose your clinic in a very far area of a main city, so you must check if any service branch is near to your area or not. How many people in the team of that particular company is working in your area in sales also, in service also. So how much technology the company have already adopted so that you can convey your message in an instant. Because in previous time, what happens, you are in connection with the salesperson only. So you will call salesperson for your problem. He will be busy in some other meeting, then he will forget your problem. So in second or third day, he will again remind. So it's better to have a mobile application or any technology or any single point service center where you can register your complaint. So you must have to check the company is advanced in terms of technology, how many sales person in your area, how many service person in your area, nearby branch office, so that in case of any problem, you can visit and you can discuss there. So these are the three main points which you have to check for an exclusive distributor. Please reminder, exclusive distributor. It means he is the only distributor for that brand only. So third question is dealer. So dealer comes in the third level. So first manufactured company, second the exclusive distributor, third is the dealer. So dealers are the part of the distributor itself. So either the dealer is also the exclusive or not. Presence in your area, so the past commitment, because dealers are the most crucial person. They can switch any company for their own personal benefit. So whenever you are purchasing any big equipment like OPGN CPCB, never directly deal with a small dealer. Go to directly at least the main exclusive distributor on the main head office through telephonic call, but never purchase a big item through a small dealer which is just switching the companies for their own purpose. Suppose 2 years ago, he was the dealer of some other company. After 1.5 years, he is dealer of some other company. After second year, he is the dealer of some other company. It means he just switching the company only for their own benefit. So if he is not loyal or consistent with the main company, then how he can be loyal or consistent with you? So you have to check the dealer commitment, the dealer presence in your area, and dealer is exclusive or not. So the last part is reference or influence. So reference and influence means either your senior practitioner, he can recommend, I'm using this OPG or this CBCD, you can purchase it. Or your batchmate, if he is using any CBCD or OPG, he can share his experience. Then marketing high. Marketing high means a company is promoting his OPG or CBCD with their own figure and facts in different marketing channels through digital media, or they are creating some hype. This is amazing OPG, this is amazing CBCD. So every time just go to the deep and check the figure and facts. A salesman, because sometimes a salesman also plays some tricks in terms of closing the deal to just close the deal only. So there is two things, buy the trick or chipkana. खरीदना और चिपकाना. सो ऑलवेज ट्राई टू परचेज इक्विपमेंट फ्रॉम एनी ऑफ द कंपनी. यू हैव टू चेक नेवर अंडर इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ एनी सीनियर प्रैक्टिशनर और बैट्समैन बिकॉज दे आर यूजिंग देयर मशीन फॉर देयर पर्पस. Your purpose may be different. Your practice scenario may be different. Your area is different. Your climate is different. Your territory is different. So if a person is practicing in Delhi, so Delhi is a head office of many big companies. So they have a good team in Delhi. But you are practicing any deep area of UP, Uttar Pradesh area. So there the approach of the company is not good. But the approach of second company is good. So you have to check the approach of the service department instead of the company itself a bit, because under the influence of under the experience of some other people, you can't decide your machine to what is right or wrong. You have to check your purpose. You have to check what type of cases you want to cover. You have to check in my area the presence of company is solid or not. In case if you have to make a call, they will come within 24 hours or not. So these are the main things what you have to check. So marketing hype, you have to check figure and fact. Sometime a company start adding ki we have installed 20 OPG in last 2 months, we have installed 30 OPG in last 3 months. Always check figure and facts. There are few companies, they always present wrong figure and facts on the different social medias like Facebook, or different Facebook group, Instagram group, or different. So you have to check figure and facts at least. Always ask the installation database before purchasing any OPG and CDCT. Always cross-check at least the 80 to 90% doctors. Suppose they have given the 10 doctors of your area. So if out of 10, 7 or 8 doctors are happy with the machine, it's a good success rate. Because there is no machine which can satisfy 100% customer. So if you are getting 80 to 90%, 70 to 80% success rate, it is really a good machine. So last part is doctor, because if doctor is planning only the implant, then you have to check if I have to purchase OPG and CDCT only for my practice. But if he has some future collaboration, suppose there are machine in CDCT segment where we can do both dental practice as well as ENT practice. So if you are planning any diagnostic center collaboration or a collaboration of your fellow dentists in your area, because in many areas there are team of doctors, team of dentists, from 15 to 20 doctors, they come together, they share the amount of CDCT and they make their own CDCT center for all the practitioner. So this is the collaboration you have to check, the add-on cases of different segment like ENT, which I told you. So you have to check, this is only practice which I want to keep, or you want to collaborate with your fellow dentists of the surrounding area to utilize the CDCT machine or OPC machine to share the revenue with each other. And you want to add on the cases of ENT also in future. So you have to check these three aspects before purchasing any OPC and CDCT machine. So now these are the following CDCT and OPG brands in India. If you are looking for Korean model, then Genore, Watek and Rayscan, these are the three Korean models which are present in India. So for the CDCT segment, again Genore, Watek, Rayscan, now there is one more company Tension which is introduced last year. The non-Korean brand, there is Carestream, Myre, Cabo, Newton, Planmeca, Actio. So these are the 7-8 companies which are present in India, both in Korean model and in non-Korean model. So now we will check the Korean model and non-Korean model. So if we are looking for the top 5 brand in India, both Korean and non-Korean, then you have to check all the OPGs are basic in equal qualities. Suppose if you are just planning for OPG only, I want to just take the OPG only, another not more feature, then both the machines are equal in OPG standard. But if you are planning for more features like TMJ, so all the companies are covering TMJ, lateral view and PA view. But Genore has one more feature, it can cover both view in single view. It means if there is any unilateral problem, or you want to check the TMJ area both on the lateral side and on the PA side, only one side of the area, only the left or right, then you can choose both the area at one time. So in other companies, you have to take two different exposure and two different OPGs in the TMJ area. So similarly, in the sinus view, both the companies are covering sinus PA view and sinus mid sagittal. But in Genore, there is only one more feature extra, which is lateral. So in lateral view, you can make a smart clinical cell, because lateral cell is a feature of cephalometric arm. So if you are planning any cephalometric arm, all the companies can cover. But in Genore, there is a small feature, lateral view. So you can make a small clinical cell from lesion to chin. So it will give the soft tissue profile also with the hard tissue profile. So it's a half cephalometric of the lateral cell. Then what take a segment means, suppose you are planning any implant surgery, any impaction surgery. So there is a restricted mouth opening or patient is showing any gag reflex. You are not able to cover the distroangular cases or any horizontal impaction. You are not able to cover the root. So in that segment, you can cover only the 5 cm narrow segment. So it will give only that much area, only the 5 cm vertical area into 10 cm height. So where you can check third molar, second molar, and the adjacent area. So it's a small FOB in a OPG segment also. But in other OPGs, like the different company, they are giving at least the segment of half of the face, left side, right side, or center side. But they can't divide into very narrow segment. So there is one more feature extra present in Genore. It's a name cubical semi-tomography, which is not present in any of the OPG available in India. So what is this cubical semi-tomography? I will show in the next slide. All the models are giving 5 years complete warranty. So warranty is similar for every machine. So in my opinion, if I cover all the OPGs in Korean model, Genore is really a good model, but among non-Korean model, Kodak KSTM is the right choice. So you can purchase either the Kodak KSTM among the non-Korean model, or among the Korean model, you can purchase the Genore because it has little more extra features. So like segmental view for the impaction surgery, they have complete lateral view for the smart SAP, HD fast and normal scans mode, cubical semi-tomography for implant practice, where you can measure the buccolingual width and the buccopalatal width for implant, because you need implant in the vertical height and in the buccolingual or buccopalatal width. So you can measure the width of the bone in buccopalatal, buccolingual as well. And sealed column to protect from the rodents and reptiles. So because in many machines there is a hole through which wiring is coming and out, and there is a chance of cutting of the wires. So self-standing, no drilling required. Unicode Denmark is exclusive partner for the last 10 years. They are dealing in Genore products from the last 10 years. And company itself is a very established company. They have more than 360 plus installation in the last 3.6 years because 4-5 months are just the part of COVID situation. Otherwise, they have more than 350 installation in just 3 years. They have already installed all the corporate hospital like Max Fortis, Globe Dental, Chen Medanta Hospital, Govan private segment. So they have good installation base and they have good quality machine. And the second choice is KSTM model in non-Korean. Both are the amazing machine. 5 years warranty, both are giving. So this is the smart clinical SAP you can make with the little V of the Genore model. And these are the cubical semi-tomography features which are utilizing doctors in first in implant practice. They can put the implant before and after. They can check the placement of implant, whether it is present, correct or not. Or they can check the implant planning. They can measure the bone width in buccopalatal section. So there is a point which we have to check. This cubical semi-tomography feature is take little more time, a little more exposure than the standard OPG. So this is a very technique sensitive procedure. You have to learn it, then you can utilize it. So many doctors are not habitual to utilize it due to some technical accuracy, because it will take little extra time and it take more effort to cover this first feature. So the accuracy is 99%. So all the doctors are not utilizing this first feature in all the Genore machine. Few are utilizing as per their requirement, few are not utilizing it. So it's a feature which is present in the machine. You can use it or you can't use it. It's your choice. But rest of the machines are similar, they are doing amazing things. So these are the important points you must check for implant practice. Dedicated CMOS sensor for OPG, CBCT and lateral SAP. If you are planning any CBCT, then FOBs and resolution. So these are the FOBs for different purposes. If you are doing endo practice, then you must have at least 3 to 4 to 4 to 5 mm small FOB. If you are doing any teeth practice, then 100 to 150 microns, then complete jaw 16 to 10 200 microns. If you are planning for face, complete face, then this is the FOB 16 cm of the width or 14 to 18 cm in the height to cover the complete face. So these are the FOBs for CBCT and these are the resolution as per the FOB. So implant library must be present in any of the CBCT machine. Metal artifact defects, volume rendering, 5 years minimum 20. So these are the type of FOBs you can check as per the practice. If you are doing any segmental implant, minimal implant in a segment, you can check the small FOB. If you are planning to put the implant in a segment, you can check the big FOB. If you complete rehabilitation case of the complete jaw, you can go with the space for 16 by 18 or 16 by 10 FOV. So these are the different FOV. So at least there must be FOV of 16 by 10. 16 is the width, 10 is the height. So if there is a height of 10 or 12 centimeter, it can cover both the zygoma bone. So you can easily cover the zygoma implant and pterygoid implant. If there is a small FOV of 10 by 8, then it is very difficult to cover the different type of implant. You can cover only the dental part, but you can't cover the ramus, zygoma or pterygoid plates. So you must have at least 10 by 16 FOV for complete type of implant practice. So these are the different views you can cover in a CBCT, because CBCT itself is a part of OPG and CBCT, OPG, all the views, GM, then CT part, sinus part, different cephalometric part. So now we can compare the CBCT. So now these are the four model, Korean model, like January Papaya, Watek, Chesa and Tenshin. These are the four Korean model which are present in India. So you can check at least the FOV is, the FOV which is present in January is the biggest one among the second biggest one with January. First is Tenshin. But Tenshin is a dedicated company only for the implant. So they are not manufacturing the Tenshin, they are just with a partnership with third vendor. They are putting their logo, they are putting their brand name on the Tenshin. They are selling with the implant packages. So if you are using only the Tenshin implant, you are the die-hard fan of Tenshin implant, you are planning only Tenshin implant, then you can merge the combo with the Tenshin CBCT, because they have installed some more CBCT with the implant packages. But you can't cover different type of cases. You can do only the good implant practice, only the Tenshin. If you are planning any diagnostic center, if you are planning any big center where you want to cover every type of cases, then Genova is a good FOV. Plus, there is a one more extra feature, which is the ENT mode. So if you are planning any diagnostic center with the ENT doctor also, then you can choose the January model. Then Watek is very old model, it's present more than 10 years now. They are giving good warranty, but small FOV. So if your practice is only within the small FOV of 8 by 10, then you can choose the Watek 10 years warranty. Otherwise, the new CBCT Chesa, they should introduce in the last 1.5 years. So they have few installation, but we have to check whether the equipment is at least 3 or 4 or 5 years old or not. So these are the four options available in India for this machine. So if we check the basic features of Watek, Racian and Tenshin and Genore, then we can see the Genore FOV is up to 16 by 14, Watek has 10 into 8, Racian has 16 by 10 and 16 by 13. They have two different FOV machines, and Tenshin has 16 by 18. The ENT mode is present in Genore, but not present in Watek. In the Racian is available, but in the higher models, Tenshin it is not available. Then DICOM to STL, because you are planning implant now, then later on after a couple of years, you will go to 3D printers. So you must have the option of 3D conversion file. So the Genology has the feature of DICOM to STL conversion, which is not present in other models. Then dental cast and molar scanning is also present. Then RayScan is giving a good option of on-demand software. So if you are the fan of on-demand software, then you can go with RayScan. Otherwise, if you are planning for CAD-CAM and CBCT together, then Genore is a good model. Then separate sensor for OPG and CBCT, it is only present in Genore, because they have the dedicated sensor with OPG and CBCT. All the machines are giving only one sensor. The same sensor will cover OPG, the same sensor will cover CBCT. It means you are giving the price of CBCT, but you are using as a OPG. So you must check the sensor life will decrease with every exposure. Then 5 years warranty for all the machine except Watek. Watek is giving 10 years warranty because they have the limitation in their machine. They have the small FOV but long peace of mind. So if you are planning, okay, I want long peace of mind, then you can go with Watek. If you want to cover more clinical number of cases, then you can cover Genore. So these all are the well established except the RayScan. RayScan is a newly launched company from the last 1.5 years. And same with the Tenshin. Tenshin is a dedicated company for implant. They are just trying this CBCT with their implant package. So the Watek and Genore are the two companies which are present more than 20 years old in the radiology department. They are the dedicated company only for the radiology. So how to select the right Korean model? If you want economical and flexi payment option, only implant practice with the one brand, only the Tenshin. So if you are only doing Tenshin implant, you don't want to switch any type of implant, you want flexi payment option means they, because they are making big packages of 1 crore, 1.5 crore, so you can cover in 5 years, 6 years, 10 years with an implant planning. But in case if you are planning long peace of mind with implant practice only implant within the small area, then you can go with the water, because it's giving 10 years warranty. So risk is only the limited case you can cover, because you can't cover the adequate implant case, you can't cover the zygoma implant case, you can cover only smaller cases. So if you are planning less radiation and on-demand 3D software with the machine, then you can go with the Chesa RayScan. They are giving the less radiation exposure as well as the on-demand software. But you want a complete machine with both the purpose as a complete diagnostic center, CAD-CAM upgraded to 3D CAD-CAM system, a diagnostic center, ENT collaboration, then you can go with the Genore. So Genore Papaya 3D is a good choice. So these are the four options you can check as per your requirement. So in non-Korean model, there are Testing, Planmaker, Actiom, Newton, Myre and Kaho. So these are the systems which are giving more value. They are giving more features like 3D face photo, 4D motion recording, automatic doses, advanced feature in software, more customization, more models as per the requirement. So if you have good money, you are not short of money, you have big budget, then you can go with the non-Korean model. But they are the features which are away from the implant. They are in the research purpose or in any theoretical part, you are doing any courses, you want to study, you want to give any study article, research publication, then you can go with the non-Korean models because they have more features. But for the implant practice, you can cover with only the system. If budget is not the problem, then first choice is Planmaker. Planmaker have two basic models, 3D plus and 3D mid. 3D plus can cover up to 16 by 10 and 3D face mid can cover up to the face. So for better reason. So if budget is not the problem, go with Planmaker. Second is Casting. Casting has a great number of installations. They are very well established brand. 9300 model or 9600 model, both are the excellent model. Then Mutom, Kaho, Actiom or the same platform, you can cover either of the machine. They have given almost similar type of technology and function. Then fourth is Myre. Myre is from the Italian product. So they are not well established in India now. So Planmaker and Casting, these are the amazing machine in non-Korean model. If budget is not the problem. So future aspect in CBCT, we are in the last part of the presentation now. So it will become the gold standard for diagnosis till 2025. Because in the next 5 years in India, CBCT will become the main and primary source of diagnosis in dental treatment. So now the second thing is artificial intelligence will play most important role, because if the installation of CBCT will rise with time in India, then you must need at least either the radiological consultation or you must need some artificial intelligence software, because you can't discuss every case with a professional radiologist because they will charge you. So in case of automatic cephalometric tracing, there are some software like ODASEP is a well professional company which is only dealing in cephalometric tracing too. So it's a well established company only for the cephalometric tracing too. They are the expert in it. Like DiagnoCAD, this is a different company for the diagnosis purpose. Just upload your CBCT case. They will diagnose all the things within a couple of minutes. They will give you the report. Then they have high level software like in vivo, on demand 3D, virtual surgical planning tools. So these are the future of software portion in India, because with the time, if there is an installation of CBCT case will rise, then different tools you need to improve your practice. So CBCT, intraoral scanner, 3D printer are the future unbeatable combo. Because if you are planning for CBCT, then you must need intraoral scanner and a 3D printer. So these three things will make your practice within a couple of hours. You will cover every type of case in just 2 or 3 hours with the CBCT, with the intraoral scanner and the 3D printer. So single day dentistry will convert into a half day dentistry or 3 hour dentistry or 4 hour dentistry. So what is the conclusion summarization? So general OPG is a more advanced and good choice among Korean model. And in non-Korean model, Kodak Casting is a good choice. Planmaker 3D mid CBCT model is good choice overall if money is not the problem and you want to feel the technology. But generally CBCT is overall the one single machine which can cover all the features and is equivalent to Planmaker except two main features, face scanning and 4D. Jaw motion, both have the all FOVs, ENT mode also, molar scanning, DICOM to STL, conversion, MVR, etc. So Vortex CBCT is good choice if looking for the long warranty only. CBCT, intraoral scanner and 3D printer are the future unbeatable combo where single day dentistry is possible with CAD-CAM. So pricing and offers, if we check the average prices of OPG in India is around 7.5 lakh. And in terms of EMI planning, it will raise up to the 8.5 lakh. And in case of OPG with cephalometric arm, the average price is 12.8 to 30 lakh. But in planning of EMI, you have to pay some extra for the interest part. Then it's around 13.5 to 14 lakh. In case of CBCT, the average CBCT is around 30 to 31 lakh. And with cephalometric arm, it will raise up to 37 to 38 lakh. So these are the CBCT's average range. So in non-Korean model, CBCT are costly as because they have different models for the FOVs. So average cost is around 40 lakhs. If you are planning for plan mega satellite Tachyon, so average cost is around 40 lakh. So offers keep changing with time because offers are just for the part of 1 month or 2 months. They keep changing with time. So, but there is always a better price in full advance payment. If you're planning for full advance payment, then you can get a good offer. So now thank you so much for this session. So now the question answer round. Because from the last 10 years, I'm taking care of this segment as well as the dental branding segment. So we help dentists to enhance their personal branding also in case of grabbing more high client patient from their area. So if you want to check those system also with us, you can contact either me or the dentist channel dot online. So we are also working on that scenario. So now this is the question answer round. I will stop sharing my screen so that I can interact with you all. Okay, so now we have few questions. So question number one is, what is the approximate life of sensor, both CBCT and OPG? So a CMO sensor, whether it is a part of RBG, CBCT or OPG, they are giving around 3 lakh exposure as an ideal condition. So CBCT and OPG life basically depended on the two factors, the type of KVMM we are using and number of exposure. So average life of CBCT and OPG per day, if you are doing 10 cases, 10 to 20 cases, it will easily run for the at least 10 years. So 10 years is the average life of a machine. The sensor life is dependent on the exposure only. So we can't determine the sensor life is 10 years, 15 years, or 2 years, or 10 years. But average ideal exposure is 3 lakh exposure on a CMO sensor. So second question is, can we check the bone quality based on HU unit in CBCT manufacturers? Yes, correct. The CBCT is showing the HU unit is a algorithm of CBCT. These are not the exact bone density. Honestly speaking, this is not the exactly bone density. This is the around 70 to 80% accuracy as per the real bone density. Because CBCT is algorithm is different as per the grayscale. So MA, KV and the bone density with these different factors, but we can't determine exact bone density of the CBCT software feature. We just say algorithm. So this is not the 100% correct. 100% correct is just explore the bone, raise the flap, then you can check by drilling. So third question is, please show the slide on conclusion of CBCT machine. Okay, I will share it. You can discuss. You can have my number from dentistchannel.online or 96719882. 96719882. You can message me. I can share. Is the cusp feature of January OPG really useful or it's a more marketing gimmick? It's useful, but it's a tricky. It's not easy. It's like doing RCTs. First time RCT, you will feel difficult. Second time, you start finding the canals. Third time, you feel easy. So it's like a RCT. You have to do at least 5 to 10 cases, then you can get the smoothness. But it is useful. Many doctors are using, many are not using for the technique. Sensitive part because it requires some type of impression also to keep the patient steady because it takes around 80 to 90 seconds to run the machine to take the different angulation shot. So 90 seconds is the time for the machine to rotate, but in normal OPG it will take 10 to 12 seconds. So extra 80 seconds we have to keep patience because machine will take different angle shots. So this is a little technique process. You have to learn it, you have to master it little more. Then you can utilize perfectly, but its accuracy is 99%. What about the CBCT KV factor? Is 100 or 120 KV is good? So as per the dental point of view, 60 to 100 KV is the enough to cover every type of cases because our dental tissues are not so much condensed like the other bony part of the body like femur, humerus. They are very tight bone, very condensed bone. But 100 to 120 KV doesn't make any sense. It doesn't make any difference. Either it is 90, 100, 110, 120, they all are giving almost the same result. we can't cut. In case of very heavy, strong build patient, like Japanese sumo wrestler or many African patients, very high build patient, then you need little high KV, but up to the 100 KV, 120 KV, you can cover every type of patient all over the world. So all the KV is good, either it is 100, 120, 110, 90, all are almost giving similar result. So these are the questions which I found on the panel. Any KSM is providing 2 years warranty? No, actually many area they are giving 2+3, or in some cases to close the deal, they are also giving 5 years complete warranty also. But if they are not giving 5 years warranty, then my suggestion is that don't go for it. Because now we have a lot of companies, at least 5 years is the minimum warranty you must need for your practice. If you are putting around 8 lakh rupees, and up to 8 lakh rupees, 5 years is a good time. So return of investment on OPG is around 1.5 years to maximum 2 years. If you are doing only 5 OPG cases per day, gradually increasing, you can easily cover in 2 years. So I have also the return of investment business plan for OPG and CPCT. You can also ask for me on my email ID or my WhatsApp number or anything, any contact media. So 5 years warranty is the must warranty you must need in every OPG and CPCT.